हेलो स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द कर्व सरफेस सबमर्ज इन द लिक्विड. ओके, इन अ प्रीवियस लेक्चर ऑलरेडी वी हैव सीन दैट देर आर फोर कर्सेस ऑफ सबमर्ज सरफेस ऑन विच द टोटल प्रेशर, फोर्स एंड द सेंटर ऑफ प्रेशर इज टू बी डिटरमाइंड. ओके, सो अमंग फोर ऑफ देम वी हैव कंप्लीटेड थ्री केसेस इन अ प्रीवियस लेक्चर विच आर वर्टिकल प्लेन सरफेस submerge in the liquid, horizontal plane surface and inclined plane surface submerge in the liquid. Okay, so in the today's lecture we are going to study curved surface submerge in the liquid. Okay, for this consider a curved surface AB, okay, which is submerged in the static fluid as shown in the figure. In the figure you can see, okay, this is the water surface and this curved surface AB is submerged in this water, okay, which is static, that is it is at the rest, it is not flowing anywhere. Okay, so this is the curved surface AB which is submerged in the water. Okay, then the let DA is the area of the small strip at the depth h from the free water. Consider this is the small strip, okay, having a area dA, okay, and this area, that is the area of the strip at the height of h from the free surface of the water. Okay, then the pressure intensity on the area dA is equal to what? Pressure is given by P is equal to rho gh. Okay, and also then after identifying the pressure, we can calculate the pressure force. Okay, that is df is equal to pressure into area. Okay, so pressure is nothing but the rho gh into the area of the strip is dA. So the pressure force df is equal to rho gh into dA. Okay, and this dA force is acts normal to the surface. Okay, hence the total force on the curved surface should be integration of this df. Okay, as we know this force df is acting normal to the surface, that then we can calculate the total force on the curved surface, which is the integration of the df. Okay, so capital F is the integration of df, means the integration of rho gh into dA. Okay, but here the direction of the force on the small areas are not in the same direction. In the figure you can see the direction of these forces on the small area dA is not in the same directions. Okay, it is varies pointiform and it, as it is a curved surface, so here the forces which are acting on this area dA is not same, or it is changing from point to point. Okay, direction of these forces are changing from point to point because of this curved surface. Okay, so and the integration of the equation for the curved surface is not possible. Okay, because the forces are changing from point to point, so we cannot integrate this curved surface. Okay, so how to solve this problem? Okay, for solving this problem, that force dA is divided or resolved into two forces, that is in the direction of the x and in the direction of the y. Okay, so these two components of df is called as an dfx and dfy. Okay, so dfx is the the force which is acting in the x direction and dfy is in the y direction. Okay, so the total force in x and y direction, that is f of x and f of y, are obtained by integrating the dfx and dfy. Okay, then we can calculate the total force on the curved surface by f is equal to square root of f of x square plus f of y square. Okay, so because of we are not integrating the equation, because of the forces are changing, direction of the forces is changing point to point, and because of this problem we are resolving this total force into the direction of the x and in the direction of the y. Okay, and then we are calculating the total force on the curved surface is equal to integration of this horizontal and vertical surfaces, that is in square root of f of x square plus f of y square. Okay, this is the total force on the curved surface. Okay, then the and inclination of the resultant with the horizontal is tan theta. Here the angle is made. Okay, so this inclination of this resultant force, df is the resultant force with the horizontal, is tan theta is equal to what? F of y upon f of x. Okay, then the force f of x. Okay, the resolving the force df into given by the equation in the x and y direction. Okay, the df is resolved into two directions, x direction and y direction. We get then df x and df y, the two components of this df. Okay, force df is split into two forces, the dfx and dfy. Okay, so dfx is equal to what? Df sin theta. Okay, here suppose the angle is made over here because of this. Okay, dfx is equal to what? Df sin theta. Okay, and d of fy is equal to df cos theta. Okay, but we know that df is equal to, we have already calculated df as rho g s dA. Okay, so put this into the equation, then we get the dfx is equal to rho g s dA sin theta and dfy is equal to rho g s dA cos theta. Okay, so we get these two forces. Again, these two forces, that is total forces in x and y directions, are f of x is equal to integration of this f of x d of f of x, and f of y is equal to integration of dfy. Okay, that is equal to f of x is equal to integration of dfx. We know that dfx is equal to rho g h da sin theta, so integration of rho g h da sin theta, which is equal to rho g integration of h da sin theta. Similarly, f of y is equal to rho g integration of h da cos theta. Okay, then in the figure here the triangle is there. Okay, that is da means this curved surface area, and the angle is over here. Okay, so consider this area in the figure, this figure showing the enlarged area da. Okay, e to f is equal to df. Okay, then from this triangle EF is equal to DA, then FG is equal to what? FG is equal to, here the theta is there. Okay, so FG is equal to DA sin theta and EG is equal to DA cos theta. Okay, then thus in the equation 3.15, means in the equation of F of A, what? dA sin theta is equal to what? dA sin theta is nothing but the fg. Okay, means what? The vertical projection of the area dA. Okay, and hence this expression, that is integration rho g hd integration of hda sin theta, representing the total force on the projected area. Okay, so rho g integration of hda sin theta is the total pressure force on the projected area of the curved surface on the vertical plane. Okay, so f of x is nothing but the total pressure force on the projected area of the curved surface on the vertical plane. Suppose in the example they ask us to find the total pressure force, then we have to calculate the value of f of x. Okay, then we are going further. Also, dA cos theta is equal to what? EG. Okay, so horizontal projection, that is equal to horizontal projection of dA, and hence the HDA is equal to HDA cos theta is the volume of the liquid containing the elementary area dA up to free surface of the liquid. In the figure you can see the dA cos theta, okay. This dA cos theta means EG is the horizontal projection, okay. This is the horizontal projection of the force dA, okay. And hence the integration of this is dA cos theta is the what? Volume of the liquid contain the elementary area dA up to the free surface of the liquid, okay. So this integration of dA cos theta is nothing but the total volume contained between the curved surface extended up to the free surface, okay. Suppose in the figure, in the example, they ask us to find out the total weight, okay. Then we have to calculate the f of y, means PG HDA integration of HDA cos theta is the total weight supported by the curved surfaces, okay. That is f of y is equal to rho g integration of HDA cos theta, that is equal to weight of the liquid supported by a curved surface up to the free surface of the liquid. That means if the example we they told us to find out the weight of the liquid, then we have to find out the value of the Fy, okay. Then in the figure 3.28, okay, look at this figure, okay. In this, the curved surface AB is not supporting the any fluid, that is AB is over here, okay, and water is on the outside of this, okay. In the previous diagram we have seen the water is on the inner side of this curved surface, and now into this figure the water is on the outer side of this curved surface, that is the curved surface AP is not supporting any fluid, okay. So for this case Fy is equal to the total weight of the imaginary liquid supported by the AB up to the free surface of water, okay. And the direction of Fy will be taken in the upward direction, okay. So this is a point which we have to keep in mind at the time of solving such a type of the example, okay. So these two cases we are going to study with deep by solving the examples on it, okay. So the first problem is compute the horizontal and vertical components of total force acting on the curved surface AB, which is in the form of the quadrant of circle of radius 2 meter, which is shown in the figure, and take the width of the gate as an unity, okay. So in the figure, in the example, what I have to calculate it is first to compute the horizontal and the vertical components, means the means we have to calculate the f of x and the f of y, okay. And what they have given, which is in the curved surface is shape of the curved surface is the quadrant, okay, of circle which is having a radius is 2 meter, and they have given the width of the gate is unity, that is 1, okay. So in the figure you can see here is the curved surface AB, okay, which is the quadrant, okay, of circle having a radius is 2 meter, okay. And also they have here the free surface of water. This curved surface is at a distance 1.5 meter from the free surface of water, okay. Then we have to calculate what f of x and f of y, and they have already given the width of the gate is 1 meter, radius of the gate is 2 meter, and okay, so the radius is 2 meter, that is a distance AO and OB is equal to what? 2 meter, okay. Then first we will calculate now the horizontal force, that is f of x, exerted by the water on the gate, which is given by, we have to calculate the f of x. F of x is nothing but the total pressure force on the projected area of a curved surface AB, okay, on the vertical plane, So we have to calculate the total pressure force on the side OB. Okay, that is the projected area of the curved surface on the vertical plane. Okay, so here which is equal to what? Projected area of the curved surface on the vertical plane is nothing but the OB. So here width is sorry, height is here OB 2 meter, and into width is width of the gate they have given already as 1 meter. So OB into 1. Okay, this is the projected area. Okay, so this f of x, as we are we know that the formula for the f of x is rho g a into h bar. Okay, we have already know the curved surface is in the water. Okay, so the density of the water is 1000, then acceleration due to gravity, that is 9.81, then area here. Okay, then here the area is the projected area of the curved surface of the vertical plane, that is the area of the portion AB. Okay, that is OB into width is 1, that is 2 into 1, that is equal to 2. Okay, so here area is 2 into 1 into, we have to calculate the h bar, that is the height of center of gravity from the free surface of the water. Okay, so this is this quadrant is placed at the 1.5 distance from the free surface of water. So 1.5 plus, as it is the quadrant, so here the center of gravity is of acting at radius upon 2, that is 2 by 2. Okay, here the radius is 2, so the value is of the height h bar is equal to 1.5 plus 2 upon 2. Okay, so after multiplying all these, we get the final value of the f of x is 40950 newton. Okay, so we have calculated the value of the f of x. Then where we have to find out the point of application of this f of x. Okay, which is equal to what? Ig upon a h bar plus h bar. Okay, here we have to calculate the Ig, that is moment of inertia of AB about its center of gravity. As this is a quadrant, so here the Ig is equal to BD cube upon 12. Okay, so 1, B is 1, D is 2, cube upon 12, that is 2 by 3 meter raised to 4. Okay, so put this value into the above equation. Okay, already we have know the value of A and also the H bar only, we are, and then we have calculated the value of Ig. Okay, so put these all values into the formula of the h bar. Okay, and find out the total quantity of the h bar, h star. Okay, the value of h star means the point of application, that is the center of pressure, is equal to 2.633 meter from the free surface. Okay, that is we have calculated the total pressure, horizontal force f of x, and its point of application. Now we will find the vertical force. Okay, so vertical force exerted by the water is given by f of y is equal to what? Nothing but the weight of the water supported by AB up to the free surface. Look into the figure. Vertical, we have to calculate the vertical force f of y. Okay, so f of y is what? The weight of the water supported by the AB, curved surface AB, up to the free surface. Okay, the weight of the water supported by the curved surface AB up to the free surface of water, that is the weight of the water into this area. Okay, that is the weight of the portion DABOC. Okay, we have to calculate the weight of the water in between the portion DABOC. Okay, so here the AOB is the quadrant and DAOC is the rectangular part. Okay, so the weight of the portion we can also written as weight of the portion AOB plus weight of the water in a DAOC. Okay, here the weight of the DOAC plus weight of water in the AOB. That is, weight is nothing but the rho g into volume of the two portions. That is, rho g is constant. Rho g is 1000 to 9.1, and then we have to calculate the volume of the quadrant and also the rectangular, which is upper on the quadrant. So, volume of the portion DAOC means in the figure the volume of the portion DAOC. That is AO into OC, AD into length into breadth. That is AD we already know 1.5, and AO is equal to what? The radius, that is 2 meter, and in plus the volume of AOB, that is the volume of the quadrant is equal to pi by 4 into AO square. That is pi by 4 into AO is 2 meter square into the width is 1 meter. Okay, so into the 1 meter. Okay, then by putting or multiplying all these terms, we get the final value of the vertical force, that is 60 F 249.1 newton. Okay, this is the value of the F of Y, that is the weight of the water supported by the AB, that is the surface up to the free surface. Okay, hope you have understand this problem well. Okay, now we will solve another problem in which we have to calculate the direction of the force also. Okay, the problem is find the magnitude and the direction of the resultant force due to water acting on a roller gate of cylinder of a cylindrical form of 4 meter diameter when the gate is placed on a dam in such a way that water is just going to spill. Okay, take the length of the gate is 8 meter. So what they have to they have asked us to find out, first find out the magnitude and direction of the resultant force. So the resultant force is nothing but the capital F. Okay, so we have to find out the value of F and also the direction of the resultant force, which is we have to calculate the tan theta, the value of the theta. Okay, and what they have given in the example, the length of the gate is 8 meter. Okay, and also they have given the radius, diameter of the roller gate, which is of 4 meter. Okay, the diameter is 4, then radius is of course 2 meter. Okay, now we have to draw the figure of this. Here the roller gate is there. Okay, so here is the circle which is having a diameter is 4. Okay, and which is placed on a dam in such a way, it is placed on a dam. Okay, in such a way that the water is just going to spill. From here the water is going to just spill. Okay, so this is a gate, roller gate, which is resting on a dam. Okay, and then we have to calculate the magnitude and direction of this resultant force due to the water, okay, which is acting on the roller gate. Okay, that is, we have to calculate the value of the F. Okay, so for calculating the value of F, first we have to calculate the horizontal force and the vertical force. Okay, so first we are calculating the horizontal force. Here the horizontal force F of X is acting on the gate, which is equal to what? F of X is equal to rho g A into H, that is pressure into area. We know that the F of X is equal to pressure into area, and pressure is nothing but the rho g into h bar into the area, that is rho f of x is equal to rho g a h bar, okay, which is equal to force on a projected area of the curved surface a c b, okay, that is the value of f of x, the force on this projected area of the curved surface a c b that we have to calculate, okay, that is the force on a o b, okay, this portion, the force which is acting on this portion we have to calculate the value of, then we have to calculate the first the area, already we have known the value of rho and g, then we have to calculate the value of a, means the area of this a o b portion, that is this round portion we have to calculate, okay, as we know that here the diameter is 4, okay, and the length of this roller gate is 8 meter. So the area of AOB is equal to 4 into A, that is 32 meter. Okay, then we have to calculate the H bar, that is the depth of center of gravity of AOB, which is equal to 4 by 2. Depth of the center of gravity, as this is a circle, the center of gravity is acting at the center of the circle, that is if the radius, if the diameter is 4, then it is acting at the center, means at the point 2 meter from the point A, okay, so here depth of the center of gravity is 4 by 2, that is 2 meter from the water surface, from here to here the center of gravity is acting at the point which is 2 meter from the free surface of water, okay, so by putting all this value into the value of f of x, means rho is 1000, g is 9.81, area that is 32 meter square and h bar is 2 meter, we get the final value of the f of x, that is 627840 newton, okay, so now we have to calculate the vertical force, okay, the vertical force, that is f of y, we have to calculate here in the figure, we have to calculate this this f of y, okay, this f of y is nothing but what, the weight of the water enclosed or supported by a curved surface ACB, okay, so here the f of y is equal to what, rho g into the volume of the portion ACB into length, that is rho g, that is 1000 to 9.1, area ACB, that is the half circle, that is equal to pi by 4 r square, pi by 2 r square into the length is 8, okay, we know that the radius is 2, okay, after putting all this value we get the final value of the vertical force, which is equal to 493104 newton, okay, so we find out the value of f of x also and f of y also, okay, what they have already asked us to find out the total force, total resultant force, so the resultant force is equal to square root of f of x square plus f of y square, putting this value we get the final value of the f of x, okay, then putting this value we get the value of f of resultant force, which is 798328 newton, okay, then we have to calculate the next point, that is the direction of this resultant force, okay, which is given by tan theta is equal to alpha pi upon f of x, okay, by putting this we get the value of tan theta as 0.7853, okay, tan theta is equal to this, then theta is equal to 31 degree 8 minutes, okay, so we have calculated the magnitude and also the direction of the resultant force due to the water acting on the roller gate, okay, then again we are solving a one more problem, okay, In this problem, they have told us the problem statement is find the horizontal and the vertical component of water pressure acting on the face of a tenor gate of 19 degree sector of radius 4 meter and take a width of the gate as unity. Okay. So we have to find out the value of f of x and the value of f of y. Okay. And they have given the radius of the gate is 4 meter. Okay. And acting in the face of the tenor gate is 19 degree sector. Okay. They have given. And they have already given the figure. Okay. So here this is the curved surface. Okay. And this is the tenor gate. Okay. Which is having a 19 sector. Okay. The angle between this in this AO and OB is 19 degree. Already they have given the example. Okay. And the radius of this gate is 4 meter. Okay, that is the value of A to O is 4 meter. Now we have to calculate the horizontal force and the vertical force. Okay, so here the radius of the gate is R is equal to 4 meter. Then the horizontal component of the force acting on the gate, horizontal component acting on the gate is equal to F of x, which is here the projected area is A C B D A. Okay, so the force on the area of the gate projected on the vertical plane is equal to A D B. That is the force on the area A D B. Okay, that is equal to rho g A into H bar. As the area is equal to what? We have to calculate the area and the of the A B into the width of the gate. So this we don't know the value of A to D, A B. Okay, but we know the value of A D. We don't know the value of A B and also the A D, but we can. So this A B is equal to 2 times A D. Okay, and here the degree is 19 degree. So after so if we consider the area that this triangle A D O, then we can calculate the value of AD as 4 sine of 45. Here the angle is 45. Okay, so this AD is equal to 4 sine of 45. Okay, so here A is equal to AB into width of the gate. So AB we can also written as 2 into AD into the width of the gate is 1. Then 2 into AD is 4 sine of 45. 4 into sine of 45 into 1. So we get the final value of the A, that is 5.656 meter square. Then we have to calculate the H bar, which is H bar, that is the height of center of gravity of this curved surface from the free surface of water. Here AB is here, so the center of gravity is acting at this at the center of this portion AB, that is H bar is equal to AB by 2. Okay, so H bar is 2.828 meter. Okay, now put this value of A bar, H bar and rho g into the value of, into the formula of F of x. Okay, by putting this and multiplying all these terms, we get the final value of F of x as 1.156911 newton. Okay, so we have calculated the value of F of x. Now we have to calculate the area the vertical component, that is the F of y. We know that F of y is nothing but the weight of the water enclosed supported or enclosed by a curved surface. Here the weight of the water supported or enclosed by a curved surface, that is we have to calculate the weight of the water in the portion ACBDA. This is the curved portion we are considering. So we have to calculate the weight of the water into this curve portion A, C, B, D, A. Okay, so weight is equal to what? Rho g into the rho g into the area of this A, C, B, D, A into the width of the gate. Okay, so here rho g into the volume. Okay, the volume of this portion is nothing but the area into width. So here rho g is 1000 into 9.81. Then we have to calculate the area of ACBDA. Okay, for finding out the value of ACBDA, volume of this, we know that the area of here we can calculate the area of this sector and also the triangle, and by subtracting the area of this triangle from the area of this sector, we can get the area of this portion ACBDA. Okay, that is the area of sector ACBOA minus the area of the triangle. We get the value of area of ACBDA into what? The width of the gate. Okay, so by putting this value 1000 into 9.81, that is 9810, into the area of sector pi by 4 r square minus the area of the triangle. Area of the triangle is 1 by 2 length into breadth, 1 upon 2 AO into BO, as it is a right angle triangle. Okay, because the 19 degree is there. Okay, so by putting all this value, we get the final value of the f of y as 44796. Okay, now we will see one more problem. Okay, here problem is calculate a horizontal and vertical component of a water pressure exerted on the tenter gate of radius 8 meter, which is as shown in the figure. Take a width of the gate is unity, that is 1. Okay, so in the figure you can see the tenter gate is there, okay, which is placed on a dam. Okay, in the previous example we have seen the same problem, but the this tenter gate that time is completely submerged in the water. But here in this example, this tenter gate, the half portion of this tenter gate is submerged in the water. Okay, so here the curved surface is only up to this C to B. Okay, then now we have to calculate the horizontal and vertical component of the water pressure exerted by this tenter gate. Okay, and the horizontal component is nothing but the f of x, which is equal to rho g a into h bar. Okay, here we have to first calculate the rho g value we already known. Then we have to calculate the area. Here we have to calculate the force on the vertical area, that is BD. Okay, so area of this BD is equal to what? This BD into the width of the gate. We know that the value of BD is 4 meter. Already they have given in the example. The value of B2D is 4 meter. And the width of the gate is unity, that is 1 meter. So the area is BD into the width of the gate, that is 4 into 1, that is 4 meter. Then we have to calculate the H bar. H bar is the center of gravity, which is the height of the center of gravity from the free surface of water. As this portion is the width of this portion is 4 meter. Okay, and here the sector. So the center of gravity is acting the half of this part, that is 1 by 2 into 4. The height is 2 meters. Okay, then putting this value in the formula of f of x, we get the final value of fx is equal to 78480 newton. Okay,
Now we have to calculate the f of y. F of y is the weight of the water supported by or enclosed by a curved surface CB. Okay, so here in the CB, the weight of the water in the position, we have to calculate the CBDC. Okay, so here we have to calculate the weight of the water in the position of this. Okay, but the weight of the water is equal to what? Rho g into the volume of this. Okay, how to calculate the volume? The area into width. Okay, so here rho g into the area of portion CBDC into the width of the gate, that is 1 meter. Okay, the area of CBDC, for finding out the area of this, we can find out the area of the sector CBO. Okay, and by subtracting the area of the triangle DBOD, okay, we get the value of the sector CBDC. Okay, which is equal to 1000 into 9.1 in bracket, the area of CBO, area of the sector, is equal to 30/360 into pi r square minus the area of triangle at the triangle here, 360 and 90 degree triangle is there. So here the area is 1/2 into length into breadth. So 1/2 length is DO, that is, and then the breadth is BD. Okay, so 1/2 BD into DO. Okay, then we don't know the value of DO, but here we know the value of angle. They have already given 30 degrees. Okay, so considering this triangle, okay, DBO, we can calculate the value of DOD, which is equal to DO is equal to BO cos 30. Okay, that is BO, we know the value of BO, which is 8 meter. So here the value of DO is equal to 8 cos of 30. Okay, so by putting these value of DO, BD we already know. Okay, by putting all this, we get the final value of vertical component 28439 Newton. Okay, then we have to we will see one more problem on the cylindrical portion which is submerged in the gas. Already we have seen the problems on the tenter gate, which is half the submerged, fully submerged in the water, and also half part of this submerged in the water. Okay, now we will see the problem on the next problem. Here we have to calculate the horizontal vertical reaction at point A and B. Okay, so ignoring the friction, here the problem is a cylinder of 3 meter in diameter. Okay, cylinder is 3 meter in diameter and 4 meter long. The length is 4 meter long. Retains a water on one side. The water is on the one side of this cylindrical. Okay, the cylinder is supported, which is shown in the figure. Already they have given the figure in the example itself. Okay, determine the horizontal reaction at A and the vertical reaction at B. Okay, and the cylindrical weight they have already given is 196.2 kilonewton. So we have to calculate the horizontal and vertical force. They have given the diameter of the cylinder is 3 meter, length of the cylinder is 4 meter, then the weight of the cylinder is 196.2 kilonewton. Convert it in the newton, which is equal to 196.200 newton. Okay, then first we have to calculate the horizontal force, which is equal to force on the vertical area BOC. Okay, this is the curved surface area. Okay, we have to calculate the force on the vertical area BOC. Okay, then the area of BOC is equal to length into breadth, that is BOC we already know, it is a 3 meter height into length is 4 meter that we are already given in the example. So BOC is equal to area of BOC is equal to 12 meter square. Okay, then we have to find out the height h bar. Okay, the h bar is the the height or the depth of the center of gravity from the free surface of water. As this is a circle, it is acting the half of the portion. Okay, so here 1 upon 2 into the diameter is 3. Okay, so it is at the 1.5 meter. H bar is equal to 1.5 meter. Then putting this value into the formula, we get the final value of horizontal force. F of x is equal to 176,580 newton. Okay, then we have to calculate the next is the vertical force exerted by the water. Okay, so here vertical force is the water of weight of the water enclosed by the B D C O B. Okay, this portion. We have to calculate the weight of the water enclosed by this portion. Okay, so here this rho g into the area into length, that is volume of this portion. So rho g into the area is here 5 by half circle na, so 5 by 4 r square into the length. So here 1000 into 9.1 5 by 4 r is 1.5 square into the length is 4 meter. Okay, then we get the final value of f of y as 138,684 newton. Okay, then what they have asked to find out the horizontal reaction at A. Okay, here so horizontal reaction at A is equal to only one horizontal reaction, that is f of x. So f of x is equal to 176,580. The horizontal reaction at A is equal to, we got the value of f of x. Then we have next, they have next we have to calculate the vertical reaction at B. Okay, so here two reactions are there. F of y is acting vertically upwards and the weight is acting vertically downwards. Okay, so the vertical reaction at point B is equal to weight of the cylinder minus the f of y. Okay, so here 196,200 minus 138,684 is equal to 57,516 newton. Okay, this is the vertical reaction at B. Okay, so in this lecture we have seen the curved surface submerged in the liquid and also solved 5 to 6 problems on the same. Okay, thank you.